Some people spend their entire lives trying to come to terms with injustices that were done to them. Why was I caused so much pain by this person? Why did I have to go through this? And it's understandable because sometimes there is no explanation that you can logically come to in this life. Others take the pain that they experienced and decide to be a pain reliever for others when they recognize that same pain. In the case of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he went through every type of hardship that you can imagine. And because he went through every type of hardship that you can imagine, he recognized that hardship. Who was rejected more than the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam? Who was poorer than the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam? Who knew emotional vulnerability more than the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam? The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam knew every type of pain and vulnerability, and because of that, it made him better equipped to care for people that otherwise would have no one notice them when they were in that pain. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentions حَقٌّ لِلسَّائِلِ وَالْمَحْرُومِ, that the people who pray at night, they have in their wealth a right for those who ask and those who don't ask, those who are forbidden from asking. And what that means is, there are people that will ask you when they're in pain, when they're in need, and there are people that will be forbidden, sometimes from their dignity, from their sense of shame, that they don't want to ask for help. And if you are a person that prays at night and pays extra attention to your Lord when others sleep, then that equips you to have a greater lens to pay attention to people that others are not paying attention to during the day. And so the Prophet ﷺ excelled at حَقٌّ لِلسَّائِلِ وَالْمَحْرُومِ, at being there for those who would ask, and at being there for those who were prohibited from asking by their circumstances. And one of the things that Ali radiallahu ta'ala anhu mentions is that the Prophet ﷺ relieved the people of three things. He would never degrade people or abuse them, sallallahu alaihi wasallam. So when the Prophet ﷺ would mention people, he wouldn't speak about them in a denigrating way. The second thing is that the Prophet ﷺ would not look after people's awrat, their private matters and their shameful things. You know, sometimes when you ask about people, you're asking in an underhanded way. You want to know, oh, have you heard about this person? What's this person up to? And you go searching for their awrat. You go searching for their faults. And the Prophet ﷺ would never ask about a person in a way of tatabba' al-awrat, going after their private matters or unveiling some of the shameful things that they do in private. And the third thing is that the Prophet ﷺ would never speak except in matters that he hoped to be rewarded for. So the Prophet ﷺ would not harm you with backbiting or gossip. And even more than that, the Prophet ﷺ would not provoke a conversation, perhaps that you would be shamed in. But instead, the Prophet ﷺ would ask about people in a way of concern. So when the Prophet ﷺ noticed you missing, then he would ask about you, not in a way of, have you heard about that person? But have you heard about that person? Are they okay? I haven't seen that person. The Prophet ﷺ also would see things in people that others would not see. Abu Hurairah radiallahu ta'ala anhu has this narration where he says that I used to be so hungry that I would sometimes pass out in hunger. And I would tie stones to my stomach. And I would be too ashamed to ask anybody for anything. Abu Hurairah radiallahu ta'ala anhu was homeless for some time. He was from Ahl al-Sufa. And he could not ask people for something. And he felt barred by his dignity and his modesty from asking people. So what did Abu Hurairah radiallahu ta'ala anhu do instead? He asked questions to people, hoping that they would notice that something was off about him. So Abu Hurairah radiallahu ta'ala anhu said, I went to Abu Bakr as-Siddiq radiallahu ta'ala anhu. And Abu Bakr is Abu Bakr. He's a man radiallahu ta'ala anhu that's experienced some of the most difficult moments with the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. He's a man of generosity, a man of nobility. He's the best person after the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. So Abu Hurairah radiallahu anhu said, I asked him a question about the Book of Allah. I asked him a tafsir question. And he said, I knew the answer, but I was hoping that Abu Bakr would look at me and notice that I was hungry. Instead, Abu Bakr as-Siddiq radiallahu ta'ala anhu, as amazing as he is, he answered the question and he went on his way. So Abu Hurairah radiallahu anhu said, I went to the next person. Who is the next person? Umar ibn al-Khattab radiallahu ta'ala anhu. And I asked him a question about the Book of Allah. And I knew the answer, but I was hoping he'd notice, but he didn't notice at all. Instead, Umar radiallahu ta'ala anhu, and he is who he is, he answered the question and he moved on. So Abu Hurairah radiallahu ta'ala anhu said, while I'm in the state of despair And I am asking these questions that are not relevant to my hunger, hoping someone will notice. The Prophet ﷺ walks by. And I want to pause here, by the way. Sometimes you see people that put out cries for help and you ignore those cries for help. Sometimes you might see someone tweet something or write something or post something that's not ordinary and you let it go. You just overlook it. But if someone's acting or speaking in a way that's not ordinary, if you love that person, you should be concerned and ask about that person. The Prophet ﷺ walks by Abu Hurairah radiallahu ta'ala anhu, and he looks at him and he smiles at Abu Hurairah radiallahu ta'ala anhu. And he says, Aba Hir. So he shortens his name, which is a means of putting him at ease, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, by calling him by a shortened version of his nickname. And Abu Hurairah radiallahu anhu says, Labbaik ya Rasulullah. Here I come, O ya Rasulullah. Here I am. What is it, ya Rasulullah? He says, follow me. So Abu Hurairah radiallahu ta'ala anhu says, I followed the Prophet ﷺ, and the Prophet ﷺ took me to this person's house, and we were served with laban. The Prophet ﷺ took that pitcher of laban, of yogurt, and he let it go around the room to everybody else, and I was afraid that nothing would be left for me until it got to me. And the Prophet ﷺ said, drink, O Abu Hurairah. And he said, I drank. And the Prophet ﷺ said, keep drinking. And he said, I kept on drinking until I could drink no more. And the Prophet ﷺ said, Aba Hir. I said, Labbaik ya Rasulullah. Here I am, O Messenger of Allah. He said, are you full? Abu Hurairah radiallahu anhu said, I'm full, ya Rasulullah. So then the Prophet ﷺ took and he drank from it as well, sallallahu alayhi wasallam. So the Prophet ﷺ would see in you pain or hunger or despair or need when others would not, because he's been there, sallallahu alayhi wasallam. He's been hungry before. He's been rejected before. He's been that person that no one would take in before. And so the Prophet ﷺ made it a point to be a comfort to those that were in that similar situation. And one of the most touching stories in that regard is a situation that the Prophet ﷺ was more familiar with than anyone else, which is the death of a child. There was a man that used to come to the gatherings of the Prophet ﷺ. And he had a child, a son, that the Prophet ﷺ loved a lot. And this was a child that was frequent in the masjid. And this man loved his son, and he would bring him, and the Prophet ﷺ would play with him. Everyone would play with him. And the man goes missing. He stopped coming to the masjid. The Prophet ﷺ said, where is he? And he asked again out of concern. He said, Ya Rasulullah, his son. He said, what happened to his son? He said, his son passed away. The Prophet ﷺ immediately, he says, let's go visit him. He goes to the man and he sees the man in intense sadness and he says, you know, what happened? And he says, my son died. And the Prophet ﷺ tells him, aren't you pleased that on the day of judgment that you will find your son standing in front of every gate of Jannah that you want and you can enter in any gate that you choose? SubhanAllah. So the man was shocked. He said, of course, Ya Rasulullah. Of course, O Messenger of Allah. And he says to the Prophet ﷺ, is this just something for me? Is this for everyone? The Prophet ﷺ says, this is for everyone. This is for the entire ummah, this gift. But subhanAllah, think about the Prophet ﷺ looking for that man. He looked for hunger. He looked for sadness. He looked for rejection. He looked for those who would not ask so that he could be a source of relief for them, because that is the epitome of the ihsan, the excellence of the Prophet ﷺ. صلوا عليه صلوا عليه صلى الله عليه وسلم